I'm sure I was at first very influenced by my mother, who had actually no time for Yiddish. She's like, what? It's a dead language and it sounds like German. I don't like one or the other. And she was very critical. And she's like, why would you want to do that? Why on earth would you want to do that? First of all, it's not your culture. Secondly, you didn't grow up in this. And it's a dead language. And it sounds like German. Like, she had all this. So when I first told her that I was, you know, interested in being doing Yiddish material, she was super critical. And we had some arguments over that, actually. Major ones. And she was critical of me doing anything Jewish. Because she felt I'm... The word imposter, I have that from her. She felt like I was pretending. And that if I'm lighting candles for Shabbat, I am trying to just please my husband, but it's not what I genuinely feel. And it cannot be, because I didn't grow up with it, so where is it coming from? And if I explained to her, well, Mom, you know, I got that need when I went to Israel, and this is what I feel, you know, people change. I reconnected with my roots, even though they may be different than yours. You don't even know you have them, and that's perfectly fine. But I feel those, and as I mentioned before, the continuity of it, just the idea that something that we're doing on Shabbat or whatever is something that's been done for hundreds of years, and going back, you know, the Hebrew, some of these Hebrew words, that those same words were spoken maybe on Masada or something like that, like, it gave me shivers. And I loved it. I just so loved it. And she had no feeling for that at all. So I think my original actually dislike of Yiddish was coming also from that.